Hey guys, it's me, Jeremy. Today is Saturday, April 3rd, 2016. Right now, as you can see, I'm walking along a trail, and this trail just happens to be right next to the right-of-way of the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad, which runs from Cumberland to Frostburg, Maryland. And I'll repeat again, it's Saturday, April 3rd, 2016. Unfortunately, the railroad's steam locomotive, Mountain Thunder, the 280 Consolidation number 734, has been sidelined with some mechanical problems today. And so, in lieu of that, the diesel locomotive they have, I forget which, you know, kind it is, but it pulled the train today instead of the 734. So right now, I believe I'm near Woodcock Hollow because I pulled up to the trail right alongside Woodcock Hollow Road. And as you can see, I'm walking along the trail, and if I pan the camera around here, you'll see I am, sorry if I'm kind of slurring my words a little bit, or, you know, not enunciating my words very well, but right now, as you can see, I have a jacket on. It's semi-chilly out here. It's probably like, I don't know, 45 to 50 degrees or something like that. My cell phone, it doesn't get nearly as good a signal out here as it does back in Cumberland, but I just thought I'd, you know, give you guys just this beautiful view on the camera real quick. Again, I'm near Woodcock Hollow, just in by this little, I don't know if you call it an embankment or what this is called right here, but this is a little area where some grass is growing, and I'm on the trail. I even forget what the trail is called. I'm so terrible at that, you know, that kind of stuff as far as surveying some of the locations before I came up here. But yes, this is the right-of-way of the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad near Woodcock Hollow. And we will not be seeing the train at all today because I believe it already went by this area. And it's probably back in Cumberland by now, but I was hoping, I drove all the way here from Baltimore hoping to see the 734 in action, but unfortunately that didn't happen. And I was talking to the lady at the gift store who works for the railroad, and she was in contact with the mechanical people down at the shops in Ridgely, West Virginia, and right now, as we speak, they are supposedly working on 734, and hopefully they will have her up and running again and get a couple good last runs out of her next weekend, which is the weekend of April 9th and April 10th, 2016. Whew, again, I'm sorry if I'm not out of breath or anything. I'm very physically fit, but, you know, it's just very cold, and I had to wear this semi... I'm turning back to me. Turning back to me now. I think you've gotten enough of the view. Wearing a semi-heavy jacket. It's like 45 to 50 degrees out here, but it's a wonderful day. It's beautiful. And I wish this camera had a zoom on it, but I'm going to be, you know, getting a new camera before next weekend. So when I film the weekend of the 9th and the 10th, hopefully they'll have the steam engine up and running again for a couple good last runs before it goes down for its 15-year inspection. And later this year they're supposed to have CNO 1309, which is the 2662 articulated, built for the Chesapeake and Ohio Railway. And they're supposed to have that up and running later this year, maybe in the fall, and I'll be coming back for, I'm panning around again, for fall foliage excursions on the WMSR. So, I hate to ramble on too much, but this will be a taste of what it's like here. Hopefully next Sunday when I come back and film. And I'm just gonna continue walking here and just shut up for a minute, and then I'll come back on and I'll say some more. Forgive me, I've never done like my own little on-camera interview before, so it's kind of awkward when you have to point the camera at yourself and speak into it and all that to an audience you don't even know. So anyway, yeah, this is really, it's really beautiful up here. I really don't know what else to say to everyone, but I took off work next weekend, and hopefully I'm praying to God that they have Mountain Thunder up and running again next weekend, because I did roll into Cumberland late today, and I did miss the train pulled by number 501, which is their diesel. But after this, I'm going to, I think, head to Helmstetter's Curve and do a little bit of filming there, and talk to you guys. So then I'll explain more detail of what's going to be happening hopefully next weekend, and then I will go over to Helmstetter's Curve and film the rest of the scenes from today that I can film for you of the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad's right-of-way and all these beautiful mountains of Western Maryland. Right now spring has sprung, and some of the trees are getting buds on them, but as you can see, everything's not totally green yet, so we may have to wait another week or a couple weeks to be able to see something like that. But if you ever come to the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad in Cumberland and ride the train from Cumberland to Frostburg, forgive me, I'm just going to keep walking some more, and then as soon as I get to the end part of this trail right here, I'm just going to cut it off and call it a day here and go over to Helmstetter's Curve and do a little practice filming. Again, this is practice filming. And just, you know, I'm just kind of scoping out things and making sure I know what I'm doing next weekend, next Sunday the 10th, when I come back and hopefully film the 734, which a lot of you know affectionately in the railfan community as Mountain Thunder, one last time before they retire her for a few years. But thankfully, the WMSR will not be without a steam engine for the remainder of the 2016 season. They'll be using the diesel 501 for a little while, I think, and then they're going to bring out 1309 when that restoration is finished. And boy, oh, she's going to be in the best shape of her life. It's a beautiful locomotive. It came from the B&O Railroad Museum in Baltimore, where I am, where I traveled from today to be here. And I've seen it, you know, parked in that museum for a while, and now they finally leased it from the museum here, and they're gonna put it into operation. It's gonna be really exciting. That locomotive will not need any diesel assistance, I believe. It's a lot more powerful than Mountain Thunder, but still, things around here definitely won't be the same for a while without Mountain Thunder, the Consolidation. I wouldn't say it's a little Consolidation, that's a little insulting. She is beat up, and like I said, you know, they told me she did have some mechanical problems, so she wasn't able to finish out the excursion yesterday on Saturday the 2nd, unfortunately, and the diesel had to bring her back to Cumberland, and there were a lot of unhappy passengers and just all that rot, unfortunately. So that's all I have to say for right now, and I'm going to turn the camera around one more time, and we'll just get to see the tracks the trail. And I'll pan it around here. Here is the beautiful mountain vistas of Western Maryland. One more time, near Woodcock Hollow. Sorry guys, no train coming through this time because I missed it. And besides, it wasn't Mountain Thunder, it was the diesel. But hopefully next weekend it'll be a different story. And by then I will have my new camcorder, my new HD camcorder, because this right here is just a Canon XS, I can't even speak. I'm sorry guys, it's so cold, forgive me. SX200IS, little 12x optical zoom photo camera, but it also records HD video. But I will be sporting a camera with a bigger chip that's actually for video recording next weekend, and hopefully you know the rest. I don't have to say anymore. I ramble on too much sometimes. Anyway, thank you guys, and we're gonna move on to the next location now. All right, peace. Hey guys, it's me again. Just real quick, I found this little mile post, and this is actually the Great Allegheny Passage, if you can see all that information at all. And that's what I've been walking along in the last little clip in this video. I mentioned that I forgot what the name of the trail was, right next to the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad right-of-way that I was walking on. So that will give you a little additional information right there. And now we're moving on to the next location. Thanks, guys. Hey, guys, it's me again. I just wanted to show you something else real quick. Right now I'm on my way back to the car at Woodcock Hollow Road, right next to the right-of-way of the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad. And I just wanted to show you something real quick. I'm going to turn this camera around. Ta-da! So this piece of equipment right here looks like it pertains to them working on the tracks. I don't believe the train was able to go any farther than this today, or actually any farther than the area that, you know, down this way that we'll show you in a minute, because of the washout that I believe is 2 miles outside of Frostburg, that big washout that happened a few weeks ago. So yeah, they wouldn't have been able to bring Mountain Thunder up any farther, and certainly not the diesel today that pulled the train, because this thing is blocking the way. Let's take a look here. WMSR. Yep. So I just wanted to take a quick second to show this to you guys, and I'm going to continue down the path for a second to this railroad crossing sign. You can barely see on the camera, but as we move closer you'll be able to see it better up here. This is kind of where the trail crosses over to the other side of the tracks, and then we start heading down to Woodcock Hollow Road, which is how I got up here in the first place. And I parked my car in a little parking area there. And hopefully, no Allegheny County Sheriff's deputies or Maryland State Troopers or anybody like that will come by and have that vehicle towed just because I parked right there. I hope you can park there. I'm gonna go see. But anyway, here's where you cross the tracks. There's a piece of equipment way back there. And as you can start to hear, there's a little waterfall type thing coming out of this limestone out of the mountainside here. I'm going to get a close-up of that in a second. Hold on. Let me switch gears here. really cool stuff. Stop. That tells you that a train is coming. If you know when the train comes through and you got to cross over to the other side, you got to stop. Plain and simple. Oop, there's my shadow. All right. That'll be the last of this scene right here for you guys, and I'm going to move on down to Woodcock Hollow Road where I parked, and there's a little area there that has a porta potty, I guess, and then there's a little sitting area if people want to watch the train and they want to take a break from the trail here right next to the right-of-way. I think they can, as long as they want, and we're going to go see that now. All right, guys, forgive me for the shakes as I continue to walk down the trail, but we are approaching Woodcock Hollow Road. The grade crossing there, where I will show you the sitting area right next to it, where people can watch the train go by and rest if they're hiking or biking along this trail right next to the right-of-way. And going to continue walking here. I'll continue filming. I won't take another pause again. You can just enjoy the scenery here. Keep this camera steady enough. Again, it's a really small camera. It is HD, 720p HD video quality, but again, like I said earlier in this video, in one of the clips, I will be getting a new camera. Very thankful that's going to happen. It'll be full 1080p HD. It is also a Canon, and I'll be hopefully filming Mountain Thunder next weekend with that piece of equipment. And as we get closer here, sorry about my breathing. I'm not out of breath or anything. I'm very physically fit. It's just that, you know, it's cold out here today. A little bit colder than I expected it to be, even wearing a semi-heavy jacket. But here's that sitting area I was talking to you about, and this grade crossing up here. We're going to continue to walk up there. Hold on a second, just for some more perspective here, guys. Here's that another one of those signs for the trail right next to the right-of-way. If I'm going slow enough for you there. Oh, I love that. Have a safe and enjoyable trip. That's the best part. That's the most important rule of all, right? So, I know I'm not very funny. I don't come up with very many good jokes, but right now we're here in the afternoon sun. I'm going to point up to the sun real quick. Hope it doesn't blind you too much. Ah, it's blinding me. But it's a beautiful day out here near Cumberland, Maryland. A few miles away from Cumberland, that is. Not too close, but we're here at Woodcock Hollow Road. Here's the grade crossing up here. And I think you can see in the corner my vehicle. It's still intact. Doesn't look like anybody's broken into it. No officers have come by and investigated me, so this is great. Back in my car here after there's some residences here. Really nice area. We're out in the boonsticks here, kind of. We're gonna have to get back to the main road pretty soon. But yeah, I think we just climbed like several hundred feet when we went up there. Yeah, we did actually. That's like a big curve. Helmstetter's curve, which we're going to next, I believe, is a little bit, you know, more intense and a little bit more of a climb for even the diesels, let alone Mountain Thunder, the steam locomotive. But all in all, you know, this is a pretty steep railroad in spots, regardless of which curves are which and all that kind of stuff. So here's the grade crossing. Oh, there's my shadow again. Here's the grade crossing at Woodcock Hollow. Again, I hope these shots have not been too shaky. And we are headed to the next location. Thanks. Alright guys, so we finally made it over to the grade crossing at Helmstetter's Curve, which is where Cache Valley Road crosses over the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad right-of-way. And here's the right-of-way. Helmstetter's Curve goes up that-a-way. And we're going to go up there in a minute and take a look at what's going on there. Right now we're going to head up to the grade crossing. Here it is, folks. One more time. All right, we're headed back up. It's a beautiful afternoon, several miles near Cumberland, Maryland. We're headed up Helmstetter's Curve right now. There's the little parking area. It'll take a little bit of walking, so we'll see you up there. Alright guys, we're halfway up there. Here's a closer shot of the sign. We're just going to walk up the trail here for a little bit, and I'll just show you, I don't know how many degrees this curve is, but I'll have to look it up and I'll tell you. But yeah, this is a very famous spot on the railroad. And it just winds and winds around like that. Anyway, I'll show you something here. Here's some information about it. I'll just kind of scroll down slowly and let y'all read it. You can pause this video whenever you want. Was enough. Here's a couple pictures. Really cool to see the history of this stuff. I think that's the original Western Maryland back in the day, back in the 50s, 60s, 70s. And now it's a tourist railroad. Like I said earlier, unfortunately, we were not able to film the train with the 734 Mountain Thunder. As y'all know, the locomotive nickname. Sorry about the wind. If there's any wind noise right now, it's kind of blowing in my damn face. Excited about that. I'm sure you are too. Yep, folks, you heard that right. I'm headed back to Manassas, Virginia. I believe it's June 4th, 5th, and 6th, or 3rd, 4th, and 5th. I have to look at the exact dates, but Norfolk and Western 611 will be running again. And I'll have a new way to take a video. You'll get to see a lot more from me on my YouTube channel here. Right now, we are in near Cumberland, Maryland, on Helmstetter's Curve, just walking up the trail. There's the barn there. I think this is Cache Valley. It's just beautiful scenery. It's like surreal. It almost reminds me of Alaska or Roanoke, Virginia, or anywhere that has mountains pretty much. It's just amazing. Oh, absolutely awe-inspiring beauty, God's creation, and a pair of train tracks. I mean, not a pair of train tracks, a set of train tracks, whatever you call it. I'm just totally taken aback right now at how beautiful this area is. All the mountains of Western Maryland in the background. I would live here out in the boonsticks. Would any of you? Comment on my video here if you, and tell me if you live in an area like this. I mean, this is just amazing. I'll give you a little background information about the first time I rode behind Mountain Thunder on the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad. It was back in October 20th of 2012 to be exact. And man, this curve is just amazing. No wonder this is a great place to take photos, and it's really famous for people wanting to take video and photos of the train coming through here. Anyway, so I guess that's Helmstetter Farm, and that's Helmstetter Barn. I'll just keep giving you views of this wonderful scenery on this beautiful sunny afternoon. But anyway, back to the story. Let's not get distracted too much. So October 20th of 2012, which is the day after my birthday, which is October 19th, I was born in 94, and I believe that's when they started running the 734 on this railroad, but of course I was just a little baby back then. But just as recently as 2012, I got to ride behind that locomotive on the excursion, and I don't remember coming around Helmstetter's Curve here very much at all. As far as the scenery and all that, I was not in the vestibule of one of the cars, believe it or not. I was actually inside one of the coaches, sitting with my family. And I didn't get to take any film of this area from the actual train itself when I was riding it. But right now, I believe, is a great opportunity that I'm taking right now to film this area without the train running over it, and just give you an idea of what the trail's like and what the scenery's like, and how hard of a This is how nasty of a little climb this is for 734 Mountain Thunder. Because back on that excursion on October 20th of 2012, when I rode the train, it seemed like the 734 was really struggling in this area, and she needed more diesel assistance than I thought was actually needed. But anyway, I'll still have to look up the degree of the curvature back there. And that probably had something to do with it, because it was a 10-car train. I counted the cars. And 501, their diesel locomotive, and 502, I believe, both had to assist the 734 that day. And she kept struggling and struggling, and I think they had some mechanical problems then too. That might explain a few things about why they have to sideline it so much. But hopefully, once 1309 is restored, I'm just going to continue to stop and look back just to give you some perspective here. And I hope I'm not rambling on too much, but still, once they get 1309 up and running, that's going to be a powerful enough steam locomotive as to where it won't need any diesel assistance whatsoever going up these grades of 1 and 1.5%, I believe, on different parts of the right-of-way here. So, as we continue to walk up here to another crossover where the trail crosses over the tracks again and goes to the other side, right after Helmstetter's Curve, I just wanted to reemphasize that I'm sure y'all are looking forward to that, and I'm certainly looking forward to it. Because the day I rode the excursion in 2012, it was quite a struggle. And it kind of made it a little anticlimactic in different moments and different spots along the route. It always sucks, you know, when they have to put a diesel behind one of the smaller steam locomotives, like, you know, a Consolidation or a Mikado or... yeah, well, a nickel plate Burke, a Chesapeake and Ohio Burke, and, you know, all the other Berkshires. They could handle grades like this easily. But a Consolidation like Mountain Thunder, it's quite a struggle, especially with the curvature, all the nasty curvature in spots. And then on top of that, a 10-car train that you have to maintain, you know, like 30 to 40 miles an hour, pulling an excursion full of passengers and all that rot. So I'm gonna go up farther, and I'm going to give you some more perspective in just a second here. All right. Thank you. Alright guys, I'm back again. So apparently, about another 3/4 of a mile to a mile up this way, past, you know, Helmstetter's Curve, someone walking along the trail here that I just met told me that the tunnel is up that way. I believe it's, brush tunnel. That's what it is. So we're going to go up and see that real quick. The current memory card I have in my camera right now, 8 gigs, it's, you know, running out of space for video. So I'm just going to try and go up here real quick and make this quick. And then we'll go back down and we'll move on to the next location, which is closer to Cumberland, I believe. And then after that, we'll call it a day. All right. See you in a minute. Rounding another bend here in a minute. And we're going to show you that tunnel. Da, 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 da. More curvature, more rail line to travel over. We'll be to the tunnel soon. Just real quick, guys. I have no idea what's supposed to happen here, but this number sign right here, right on the rail, I have no idea what it's there for, but it probably has something to do with that track work. So we will see. And we're going to continue to walk up this way towards the tunnel. See you in a minute. All right, guys. We are finally here at Brush Tunnel. There's the mountain it's drilled into. There's the actual tunnel. I know the lighting's kind of funky in the afternoon with this camera, so I know it might be kind of hard for you to see exactly where it is, because I can hardly see right now, but yeah, we're going to approach it here in a second. I'll just give you some perspective of where we're at with the tracks right here. Wow, it's beautiful up here. Beautiful afternoon sun. That's looking back the other way towards Cumberland. We're on the trail right now. I'll just give you a view of that sign one more time. That's a very smart warning right there. Do not enter tunnel with oncoming train. When train is approach, yeah, whatever. I can't read too well. I'm trying to focus on the camera, but it's a very small LED screen that I have on this camera. There we go. Low level lighting in tunnel. Remove sunglasses. Walk back through tunnel. Very smart. Especially when mountain thunder's going through here. And those of you who kind of maybe just tuned in halfway through the video here and you do not know what I'm referring to, by saying mountain thunder, I mean the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad's restored Consolidation 280 steam locomotive number 734, which they affectionately in these parts of Maryland call Mountain Thunder. They've given her that nickname. She was sidelined with mechanical problems yesterday, apparently, as I learned back in Cumberland from one of the railroad workers, one of their officials, and is not running any excursions today, unfortunately. But we still get to scope out the situation here. And hopefully next weekend, when I come back and film the train, they'll have Mountain Thunder running again one more time before she goes down for her 15-year inspection. And hopefully she will not be sidelined with mechanical problems on that Sunday. But suffice it to say, they will have another steam locomotive, and I'm saying this as we enter the tunnel. It's pretty cool in here. I can hear my echo, and of course they have this little guardrail thing here, this little fence to keep people from running into the tracks and into the train when it comes through here. I'm just going to pause this for a second and then we'll get some different perspective and I'll continue talking. Okay, folks, we only have a limited amount of time here, so basically as I was saying before, we are in Brush Tunnel right now. Here's the Western Maryland Scenic Railroad right-of-way, and the trail runs right next to it here in the tunnel. I could absolutely go over just a few feet there and walk on the tracks, because there are no excursions for the rest of the day today. They've already happened. Not with Mountain Thunder, however, but with the 501 and 502, the two diesels they have. I'm just gonna continue walking. I know it might be kind of dark in here, but I hope you'd continue to, as we, you know, get near the little bit of lighting they have in here in certain spots. There we go. We'll just pause right here. Take a look at the trail. Tracks are right next to it here. This is a really cool idea. Years ago, instead of converting this line to a rails to trails entirely, they have the tourist railroad, and then they also have the trail right next to it, which is, I've always thought, was a really, really neat idea. They should definitely do that elsewhere in the country. And I'm sure in some parts they do at different tourist railroads, but I forget which ones specifically right now. Anyway, folks, I'm almost running out of video, so we're gonna head back down. All right, folks, here's one more look, one last look at the last part of Helmstetter's Curve. Actually, the first part if you're going up to Frostburg, but the remainder of it if you're going back to Cumberland. What a beautiful afternoon. Just one more time here. This picturesque beauty. Oh, wish I could see stuff like this every day. So I guess that's one good part about a practice round with no train. Yep, despite no steam excursion, this was totally worth the drive. Really. You can take your spouse here, your kids here, your friends here. It's a wonderful trail right next to the right-of-way of the railroad. Helmstetter's Curve near Cumberland. Check it out. Next time you're here. Here's how it banks a little bit. I know it's kind of hard to tell, but these tracks are banking a little bit too. Just a little bit. That's probably one of the other things that makes this curve such a nasty pull for Mountain Thunder whenever she comes up here. That locomotive is almost toast. But you can't beat this scenery, and hopefully Mountain Thunder will be running one more time next weekend, We'll catch her. It'll be a great last hurrah for that locomotive. And then we'll come back in the fall and see all the pretty fall colors in this scenery, and then the other steam locomotive will be up and running.